Hey, horse people. Crazy mules. So I was, I found a lady who does pretty good feet, and I was gonna have her come out, but she ended up canceling. You know, farriers wonder why nobody's ready and nobody takes them seriously. And I'll tell you, my experience with most farriers are they're freaking scatterbrain, always got excuses, never on time. It's just, but anyway, I digress. So I'm gonna do, somebody wanted me to talk about saddle pad and whether or not, how thick a saddle pad should be and saddle fit and all that. So I'm gonna do that video with Buddy. I haven't done Buddy's feet yet. It's been so muddy and wet and damp. So his look pretty good. Mr. T's I just did, but I'm not happy with one of them. So I figured I'd let you guys look and see what you think on which one I'm not happy with. So let's have a little test here. Mr. T's like, don't be testing on me. Just chill out, boy. All right, so we'll look at the two front feet. What should I change? Is there something wrong? And then I'll move over here. And we'll do the two back feet, and we'll say, where's the back feet? Oh man, they're in the shade. I don't know if you guys can see them or not. Okay, yeah, it comes in. So there's that one, and there's that one. So I'm not happy with one of them. Which one do you think it is? Some damn farriers out there, I'm not happy with any of them. You don't know what the hell you're, shut up, you big dummy. All right, so the one I'm not, the front I'm okay with. They're okay. The back one, the right one, as I looked at it, this one just looks a little pointed to me. See how it comes to a point at the toe instead of round like that one? Can you notice now that I pointed it out? I just, when I looked at it, and it looked worse on the other side. Let me move to the other side. I know the wind's out here blowing. I gotta zoom out so I can find the screen. Alright. So, more round. See that little point there? I just don't like that little point. Is it critical? Would it wear off? Probably. But I was just going to go ahead and touch that up. So I'll leave this on the video here while I touch that up. Damn, I thought I was finished. Well, old man, you were finished. And then Dad noticed he messed up one of your little toes. So we got to do this one again. I know. I don't like it either. Good boy. Oh my goodness. Oh, he's such a good boy. So, I'm just gonna. Kind of take some off this toe here. And that could have been, I didn't really take a whole bunch off. Could have been a little bit of an optical illusion. Sometimes I'll flat spot the toe because he wears it out anyway, just a little bit because he drags it, but that wasn't my intent. Hold on, Mr. T. Don't move. Easy. I'm almost finished. See if that's any better, and if y'all see what I was looking at or what I was seeing. I just thought the point came a little pointy.
Buddy's like, Dad, be quiet, I'm trying to sleep. Look at his sleepy eye. Rock-a-bye, buddy, on the halter.
All right. So now, can you see the little difference that I did? Maybe it looks the same. I just took a little bit more off that toe there because I thought it was a little pointy. And now they look a little bit more uniform. It almost still looks a little pointy to me, but not critical. You know, most people think these hooves are probably fine. I think they're okay. Because it's been so watery and wet, they're cutting easier. Buddies look like crap. Look at that big inside toe. It take a whole bunch off that one. See how that toe's sticking out there? See how it's kind of flat on the front? And then he starts getting those toes. See how this one's kind of boxy? It's not round anymore. When I'm finished, it'll be round. Maybe I'll go ahead and do him, and then I'll turn it back on. So you can see how that rounds out. Remember that picture. And then I'll try to snap it and cut it back. Okay, so this is after the trim. Buddy's in trouble. You notice Mr. T's gone. Mr. T's way out there in pasture. Buddy's having a fit. Me and him been fighting like two damn wild dogs in a freaking bag. I swear that horse just irritates the hell out of me sometimes. It's different when a horse is being who knows what he's supposed to do and then ignores it and doesn't, versus a horse that doesn't know and you're trying to teach him and he just doesn't know the right answer. You notice Buddy's tied up short, keeps looking for Mr. T. I was going to saddle him up, and I didn't want to do a revenge ride. I go out there and just ride the shit out of him because he made me work so damn hard to do his feet because he couldn't stand still. But anyway, I wanted you to see his feet afterwards. I'm surprised he ain't bleeding it with scars. I had to call a vet. Beat that damn horse like a redheaded stepchild. Can't keep still like a damn chicken on crack all the time. Alright, so you notice they're rounded out now. They're not that square boxy. Of course, he won't keep his damn feet still. Because he's just doing everything to irritate me. I'll leave him tied up all day. I'll make a part three tonight after he's tied up for 14 hours. Just because he's being a damn hard-headed mutt. I'm gonna beat you! You, God, you irritate me, boy. I swear. There just ain't no damn sense in it. You know, cute's one thing, but he's gotta know when to listen. And I'll tell you, man, he was just picking on Mr. T, grabbed his rope, pulled Mr. T, had to get him off that. Then he put his butt, pushed Mr. T to the side. Then he wouldn't stand still. Ugh! I was ready to beat you, I swear. You ain't even cute anymore. You're just mean. I know everybody's on YouTube. How could you say that? He hates being tied short, and I don't like tying my horses short. Oh yeah, I forgot. He was chewing on the damn rocks over here. I'm trying to do Mr. T's feet, and he's got his damn nose over there chewing on the rocks. Then he knocks the camera over that's sitting over there. Then he knocks the tools off the bench. Now, obviously, if I hadn't put it close enough to where I would hit it, if I hadn't put it on the bench, he could have knocked it over. So it's my fault, but he knows what he's doing. He's doing it just to irritate me. You want to go see Mr. T, don't you? I know you do. He is going to act like a wild freaking horse. I'm going to open this because he's ready to get the hell out of here. He is pissed. I'm going to open up this gate and you watch him run out there and freaking scream and holler to Mr. T.
Don't even laugh. I'm not laughing at you. You're in big trouble.
I know he's gonna run off. Look at that tail. You really don't think you're getting any treats? You lost your damn mind. Get out there to Miss T. You're in big trouble. Miss T's like, leave me alone. You are nothing but problems. Trying out his new hooves. He's like, hey, these are smaller. Don't you have fun, you're in trouble. Where'd he go? Hell, I lost him. There he is. Surprised he ain't biting Mr. T. There, good boy, Mr. T. He's had enough of him too. I hope he chews his butt. Man, he had poor Mr. T's rope and was shaking it. Mr. T was pulling back. I was so irritated with him. I swear, sometimes I do want to just feed him like a redheaded stepchild. Mr. T's like, I'm old. Mr. T was cracking when I was doing his feet. His bones were cracking. I have to go really slow with him. Alright, we'll end that there. I ought to go get the damn motorcycle out and make him run and get some of that piss and vinegar out of him. That's what I should have done before I did his feet, so he'd be tired. Alright, Lynette there. Mr. T, you're a good boy! Buddy, you're in big trouble! Alright, I guess we'll end it with a little,
Where's that Smokey? He was over here with his dad. Come here! He's sitting on his bed.
You know you like to come get on the truck with Dad. So, it's the sun's out. Oh, there goes Smokey. He's leaving.
Smokey! Why ain't you saying hi to your dad, boy?
I don't know where he's going. He's looking for trouble. So anyway, it's a good Texas day here. Finally, the damn rain stopped. Did the horse's feet. Gave him some hay after I got unpissed at Buddy because he was being a pain in the butt doing, being mean to Mr. T and giving me a hard time. So I figured I would clip in this little clip. I thought I was going to get Smokey over here, but he was rolling around following me. Then I went and got the camera, and he's like, I'm out of here. I think he's holding out for more money. He's got an agent. This guy keeps calling me. I keep hanging up on him. He don't need no damn agent. Buddy's got an agent. That's enough. All right, well, I figured I would end with a nice little picture of the boys having a little snack. All right, well, oh, there's the rooster out there. He's kind of looking pretty good out there. Where's he at? Oh, shit. Those damn sprinklers. People think I'm watering my grass. These are not sprinklers to water the grass, people. That's my septic system. And it goes through two filters and chlorine, and then it disperses the water. I think it's called aerobic or something. Anaerobic, aerobic, something. The old sewage system used to have leach lines, and it would just leach in the ground. With animals, that's not good because they'll walk on it, they'll break it. Sometimes they freeze, sometimes they get cluttered. This water, they say, is drinkable by the time it gets out here squirting the sprinklers. It makes the grass green, so the horses love eating in that where it sprinkles. But people think I'm watering the grass. They go, why do you water when it's raining? I'm not watering the grass. That thing kicks on automatically. Kicks on when the horses are near too. They're always like, oh shit, the rain just came on. Alright, rolling it there. Smokey, where you at, boy? You better get over here, you're gonna be in big trouble. Smokey, move! I don't know where he went. Alright, rolling that there. Okay, I found him. He's over there going out of the yard. He knows he's not supposed to be going over there. He's going over there to start trouble. He stopped. I know people are going to hate me. Watch this. Watch how I get him back over here. He knows I'm watching him. See, he's looking back. It's like, I hope Dad don't go get that BB gun and start shooting at me. That's exactly what I'm going to do. You better get back over here, boy. I'll get that BB gun. Don't make me get the BB gun. If he gets it, I'll catch him by that fence. I'll shoot that BB gun. He'll come hauling my back. I know, but you're gonna take his. Oh, I only pump it once. It barely reaches it. Just hits the grass around him, scares him. Nope, he's going back over there. He's in big trouble. I'm getting a BB gun. Watch this. Watch how you train a cat to come back to a BB gun. People are like, you can't train to come back. Watch this. Hey! You better get back at him. Normally, I know people be real mad. Ooh, he's got a BB gun. Man, when he hears that sucker. And he learned quick, too, man. Him and that cat were meeting at the fence line fighting. So I'd shoot this BB gun at him. And I don't care which one I hit, but it wasn't pumped up real good. But, man, from then on, when I pulled this BB gun out, he's like, dope! He calls up back. That's the only way I can keep him in the yard. He wants to go over there and fight. He don't need to be going over there fighting. I know I'm going to get some hate mail. I didn't even shoot him. Hell, I hold my hand, shoot my hand. It ain't even that bad. There. Didn't even hurt. People crying and whining. All right, pulling out there. Smokey got the troll. Let me go show you where he's hiding. People be like, you're mean. Y'all be quiet. Let me see if he went in his little house. He usually runs in his little house in here and hides. He's like, shit, I'm in trouble. Sometimes he must have went in. See his little cat door. That cushion blocks the wind and rain from going in there because he likes to live right there and watch us when I open this up. He'll be like, damn, Dad knew where I was hiding. Did you get in trouble? Dad told you not to go over there. You're going to be in big trouble. I can't let you go over there get in a fight. Get diseased, you get hurt. Alright, I wanted to show YouTubies where you go and hide. You're a good boy. You came home. I know. You know Dad still loves you.
You know Dad still loves you, even though you're going to get a spanking because you don't listen. You do not listen. You go to that other house, and then Dad has to spank you. So you're bad kitty. You're going to get big spanking. No more Mr. Nice Die, mister. You stay out of that other neighbor's yard and fight with those cats. You're going to get in big trouble. Not going to put up with that.
All right. That's Smokey getting in trouble. Well, in that there.